Good evening and welcome to the Dark Mom Consortium for February the 9th, 2020. I was going to say 2019. God, I'm turning into a space cadet. Ah, which I guess is appropriate, right? Let's get all the correct mics turned on. All right, all the correct mics are turned on. Yay! So how's everyone doing tonight? So if you would like to join me in Discord, I am in Discord, frequently in disarray, so I guess that's appropriate. And yes, I think the mics are set correctly, but let's double check by going in.
Set correctly.
Oh, yes. Yes, definitely. I can hear me there. That would be really spacey if I could do that. Let's see what's going on here. Hold on a second. It works better when you set the dates right. McWraith. All right. So, made somebody some omnis. Ed made an omni and I made an omni. I'm not going to take all the credit for Ed's work, too. And they came out of the oven better done than the lemon cake I made last week. Before you ask, today's beverage is Canada Dry Raspberry Sparkling Seltzer Water. Not a winner. Tastes like artificial raspberries. Probably because it's made with artificial raspberries. All right, let's get to the mail here. And we'll compose something for McWraith. And, whoops, let's not do that. Him, over here. And let's find the omnis that we made him. So, come here, little omnis. This is the Polaron that went to cup. No, that is not the Polaron I made him. Where's your Polaron? This is the Tetrion, which I took up to 15. Where is your Polaron that I made you? Come now. I made you a lovely Mark 15. Did I have leveled something else up by mistake? Wouldn't that have been embarrassing? No, there it is. There we go. I knew I'd made him something nice. Come on. Go over there. Discount bind on equip. Doesn't want to go. Very interesting. Let's close that out and let's try that again. Does anybody else ever have problems with this for mail when you're trying to mail items? That sometimes it just doesn't like to go. There they go. That's one. Now where's the other one? That's the Tetrions. Where is the Polaron? Where's the Polaron I made him? Gosh darn it. It's Mark 12. But I leveled up a Mark 15 for you. I leveled up a Mark 15. I spent a bunch on it. Oh well. Maybe I spent a bunch on something else. Go ahead and sort those out. Let's make sure we don't have a level 15. That's my omnidirectional. This is the Polaron. I guess I leveled something else up by mistake. Well, that's embarrassing and expensive.
You leveled what up?
I apparently leveled up one of my own pieces of equipment when I was trying to level up something for Ivo.
Oops. Oh.
Yeah, I cooked him a nice Polaron. And
I've been trying to talk to you for the past 40 or 50 seconds. Oh. I only realized my microphone was turned off.
Sounds like me.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, well, I leveled up something nice for myself. But, you know, what the heck's the point of leveling up stuff if you can't have some fun?
Right.
And this one came out of the cooker really nice, so but let's go over to Phoenix for that one. Just want to take it to 15 because it already came out ultra rare. I think that's good enough. I was hoping to go epic with it, but hey, you can't win them all. And how are you doing?
I'm doing okay. I actually, I'm just kind of getting off of a break from Stowe from earlier today, and I finally went through those new episodes, both of them.
Okay, your
and,
thoughts?
My thoughts?
Yeah.
The assimilated Iconian was awesome.
Okay, I haven't gotten to that part yet, so I've only done the first one. But that, you're not going to spoil anything. Don't worry.
All right. Well, I think I've already spoiled more than I should have, so I'll just leave it at that. Yeah, it was, one little piece that I thought was a little cheesy, but for the most part, it was really good.
The only comment I've consistently heard has been it's a little wordy.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I can say that about a lot of the episodes in this thing.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I timed out. I was doing them because I wanted to get the phasers for as many as possible before the patch last time. Uh-huh. And even with going through all of the dialogue, it just click, 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 click. It was coming out at 30 minutes.
Yeah. I'm not surprised to hear that.
Yeah. And I looked at the time for
that
the first
time. That sounds about right, really.
Yeah, when I was looking at the first time through for just regular run through and reading everything and enjoying it, it was 51 minutes for an episode. That's a full television episode.
Yeah.
That's a lot of stuff. Mm-hmm. I think though, it kind of points out to me that I'm not as set up or as well set up for ground as I thought I was, because there was a lot of times it's just tedious, and I thought I had a pretty good ground set up.
Yeah, it's well. I mean, I got my one gym at R that I'm still working on. That's got a horrible setup on it, but.
Yeah, mine's still got its basic setup.
I always think I have a great setup until something proves that I don't. So.
Well, yeah, that's kind of the way it goes.
Yes.
Oops. Yeah, 2,500, good enough.
And I will give you this one spoiler.
Mm-hmm.
One of the rewards for the second one is an axe.
Is that the presidential hand axe?
Yes. And I keep thinking about that movie, Abraham Lincoln
Vampire Hunter. Yes. Oh, yeah. As soon as I saw that, somebody showed it to me a couple of weeks ago, and I'm like, hold on. And we got into the whole Abraham Lincoln thing. I liked that movie.
Yeah, that was pretty good. I'm kind of tempted to just kind of try this out to see if it's any good. You know, because yeah, I kind of experimented with these Tetrion dual rifles.
Yeah,
and Celine, the character I did this on, she already has the dual. Forgot what they're called. They're the ones from the temporal defense dual pistols.
I know which ones you're talking about.
Of course, they've already been upgraded to 15. Yep. They're still just very rare though. But
I'm using the Mirror Universe phaser dual pistols, which I took to 14 because. Mm-hmm.
But yeah. I'm kind of looking at the Tetrions, these Game Rewards Tetrions are actually more powerful than the Chronotons that Celine has, but for some odd reason, those Tetrion pistols are more effective than what these Tetrions ones are. But I don't know why, but they are. But anyhow, I'm just here trying to get through my endeavors.
And I've not done my endeavors.
So far, I've only done one, and that's salvage.
Okay, I haven't done the six systems in Tour of the Galaxy, which I will do. Yes, Sof, I'm streaming. So I haven't done the Tour of the Galaxy, and then the ones I got are 5 Herald ships, 2 Lukari TFOs, and 2,000 plasma on the ground. Oh my god, I'm not going to do Heralds and Lukari TFOs. Unless there's a good Lukari TFO, and I can't think of one.
I like the Draenor Gauntlet.
The ground one?
No, the space one.
The space one.
Hello.
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 Hello. I'm sorry, I have to get this.
Quantus. There we go.
And how are you, sir?
I am doing well, other than I was up till 4:30 in the morning.
Yes.
Trying to get my third Lukari TFO, and I'm in my last Synkethi front, and I'm on 4 out of 5 stations destroyed.
Yeah.
But none of them are smart enough, even regardless of me saying all this stuff in chat, hey, protect me, I got a bomb. Let's go destroy it.
Oh, God.
Hey.
Oh, yeah.
Ignore those ships. You don't win this by killing ships.
Yeah. It's,
I was rather irritated because that was the last 8,000 I needed for my next perk.
Oh, jeez. Did you ever get it?
No.
Ah.
I had been in there for an hour.
I believe it. Well, did people leave or were they just sticking in there or were they AFK?
One person had left.
That makes it tough on that one.
Yeah, I imagine.
Man, I've got... no, I'm just not going to do Lukari. There is no way I'm going to do that one tonight.
See, which one did I do earlier today where somebody had left? I'm trying to figure out.
Deal AP damage on the ground. I can live with AP damage on the ground. A lot
AP
better.
Damage is not bad.
Yeah, no. Got ground plasma, ground AP, and destroy Herald ships.
I need to destroy Voth ships in the Dyson Sphere.
I've got Tholian ships, and then I got Herc frigates.
Hey, you know, we could go do all three of those if you want to.
Okay.
I'm happy to do that. Since it seems to be a quiet... It was a quiet evening. Oh, Savson chat! Woohoo!
Okay.
Yeah, and some TFOs, people don't even look at chat and don't realize that some missions, it's important not to kill things looking at Procyon 5. So freaking true.
Yeah.
Hey, Lant, if you're a lifer, you know, you can just turn in rep boxes for your dill farming. I mean, it's 22 clicks for 4,000 dill, but it's, you know, stupid easy. Then when you feel like farming, you can farm.
Say that again?
If you have a lifetime... Actually, no, you don't even have to be a lifer. All you have to do is in your reputations, click on the continue expedition support hourly, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
You get a box, right? It gives you 340 dilithium. It costs you some energy credits, some marks, and some expertise. But that's it. It's 2 clicks, and it's 340 dilithium. There's 11 reputations. That means it is 4,000, roughly. So you do it twice. It's a 1-hour cooldown.
Okay.
It's really easy. And that's it. And then the best part is you get the box of goodies, right?
Mm-hmm. And if you don't want them, you can sell them because they may have, you can get pretty decent EC out of them.
Well, you can't sell them, but you can trade them in at the vendors.
And yeah, that's what I meant.
Right. And you get back, for the most part, you get everything back plus on your EC. There's a few where you lose uneasy, and that would be competitive. You never make your money back because that stuff won't trade in and it won't sell.
Right.
Well, you get 10,000 every box you open.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. You actually get EC when you open the boxes.
Oh, yeah. But you actually make back enough, with the exception of competitive. Mm-hmm. Every now and then you'll get something that's just garbage. But between 6 and 22% of them open as elite marks, which is even better. Hmm. Lance says he does Admiralty on... Okay, I'm going to do this again. It's Admiralty, not Admiralty. Sorry.
Admiralty.
It's not Admiralty, it's Admiralty.
Is somebody misspelling it?
Everybody says it wrong. They say it wrong.
Admiralty?
Admiralty. Go look at how it's spelled. Admiralty. It's an admiral.
I've always pronounced it correctly.
Oh, good. Yeah, you.
Oh, admiralty. Okay.
Yeah. People say admiralty. DT does it, I think, just because he knows it's one of my pet peeves. Yes. No. Admiralty, Mom. It's like my grandmother saying aluminium.
That's actually how you pronounce it in German, though.
I know.
Aluminum.
Oh, but it's, let's see, what's the other one in German that's word? Iron. I used to work in a foundry business, and they were discussing the simulation of iron casting. I'm like, it's iron. Not in Germany.
Iron. Okay.
Iron. Yeah. It took me a long time to get used to that, and actually after almost 10 years there, it's still like, not saying it right. But, hey, at least they said a lot
of
them right.
Hey, potato, potato.
This is true. They paid me a nice paycheck, so I should have just shut up and let them say whatever they wanted to.
Yeah.
So they're...
Yeah. Laboratory.
Yeah, according to WC, the Australians also say aluminium, too. Aluminium.
Aluminium.
Mom does not feud with the English language.
Aluminium. Well, I mean... I live in Amarillo, Texas. Mm-hmm. Its actual correct pronunciation is amarillo, because yes. It's a Spanish word.
Yes, it is.
But if you insist on saying it that way, there's a lot of people in this era that will get quite offended, because it is a Spanish pronunciation and you're speaking in English. So.
Well, there are people...
So sometimes you just got to go with the flow.
Yeah, people here say Chicago. People who aren't from here say Chicago. And it's very obvious who doesn't live here.
Chicago.
It's
kind of like Miami. That's another thing. Miami and Miami. Because just a little ways northeast of here is this little itty bitty town called Miami, Texas.
Yeah.
But if you ever go down there, that will, and pronounce it that way, that will be quick to correct your pronunciation. It's Miami. Which is ironic because we here in Texas think that we're all happy, so we should smile when we name the pronunciation of our tents, Miami.
When my flight landed in Sydney and I had to make a connection to the place I was going, the very nice lady said, well, where are you going? I said, I'm going to Melbourne. And she looked at me like, where? Melbourne? It's a big city? And she goes, oh, Melbourne. I'm like, yeah. Big city?
Didn't get that R out. Getting to get that R out.
Yeah, it threw me.
Sometimes
for a while.
That's just an accent, though. There's a lot of accents where the R just doesn't come into play.
This is true, but I would bet that WC agrees with me that it is Melbourne. Okay, Sovereign says there's a quaint little town in Connecticut named Mianus. Yes, WC says that annoys me, and we all know Melbourne is Melbourne.
Oh. Then why is there an R?
Because they're Australians.
Okay.
Or as they say, Stryans.
Is this the prison colony talking?
I gotta say, it's one of the coolest places I've ever been, with relatively nice people compared to...
If I remember, wasn't Australia originally set up as a prison colony?
Yes, it was.
Yes, it was.
Yep. They took a whole bunch of people and threw them out there because of a number of reasons. But you know what? Sometimes your criminal portion of the population actually has some really good, inventive, and clever ideas, and throwing them out isn't to your advantage.
Apparently not a boat.
The Melbourne identity, Sav. The Melbourne identity. So I was going to say, like that place down in Kentucky, which is Louisville to everybody else, but around here is Louisville.
Hmm. Well, I am heading down to, where is it?
Hi, Pie.
That's one of my favorite quizzes for people like to screw people up.
Yeah.
How do you pronounce the capital of Kentucky? Louisville or Louisville?
I don't even know what the capital of Kentucky is.
I was going to say that. I don't know what the capital of Kentucky is.
I just asked.
Is it Louisville?
How do you pronounce the capital of Kentucky? Capital. Is it Louisville or
Louisville? Oh, Louisville. Oh, is that the capital? Louisville. Okay. That's how I pronounce it, Louisville.
Frankfurt, but
yeah, I was going to say, I just looked it up. It's pronounced Frankfurt, but...
Mistake, mistake that Louisville is the capital.
Yeah, I would have.
I am headed to Betelanka to kill some Tholians.
Okay, I will join you. Want to send an invite? Where are you going to kill Tholians?
Betelanka, it's a patrol.
Is where it?
There's a lot.
You know, there's one at Archer too, for Tholians.
I've played both of those. Betelanka, it's just a little bit different. It's you're not just shooting things. There's kind of more or less a puzzle.
I don't understand this not just shooting things concept. Somebody did this earlier to me today.
Maybe I should introduce you to Space Invaders then. Or asteroids.
Let's see. Bwa-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha is... Da-da-da, where is it, roughly?
It is... Da-da-da. It is... it's a little bit north of Kronos, I think. Where am I at?
Oh, goody. My dogs are outside barking at things.
Yeah, it's in the Mimpa sector, which is a little bit north and ever little, like one section up and
there it is.
One section to the right of, yeah.
It's southeast of Erickson.
Yes.
That works.
Yeah, it's actually one of the Romulan patrols, believe it or not.
Wow. Tells you often. Sanders, Kentucky, Sof. I've actually been in Sanders, Kentucky. I had to work there for 3 days of hell. People there don't drink water. I'm not joking about that. They drink sweet tea or Mountain Dew, and I had to do venipunctures on people, and you could not get the blood out of their veins. It was so thick. It was shocking. And that's what we did for 7 hours a day, is stuck needles in people. But they paid me a lot of money to do it, so what the heck.
Hey, always a good reason to do something.
Yep. Give me money. Oops, not the place I wanted to go. Why did I do that? Beta long ago. There we go. So Sob says, Australia also has 9 of the 10 most venomous animals. What's revolting? That is stuck needles in people who had blood made out of sugar? Yeah. Yeah. And then we decided to go out to lunch on one of our breaks when we went to a local diner type place, and all the people who were working in that building came there, and they were all eating chips and fries and deep fried stuff and Mountain Dew.
And where was this at?
Sanders, Kentucky.
Hmm. Of course, it was, Southern. Not all Southerners are that bad. Please understand.
No, definitely not. This, though, just was absolutely appalling. I'm usually really good at sticking people, and I could not draw blood on half these people. And we had a doctor who was with us. He couldn't get their veins. And these are big people, like 300-400-pound people, which normally are, excuse the terminology, an easy stick. Okay, I'm trying beta long call. Oh, did you want some help, by the way?
Oh, either way.
Okay, well, hang on. Let me jump out of here before I do this. And why don't you send me an invite and we can do this together?
Okay.
Just send me an invite to team.
Okay. All right. Okay, you may have to instruct me on how to...
Okay. I'm going to put an X in chat. Where is he there?
Uh-huh.
Right-click on my name.
Uh-huh.
Should be able to
invite to team.
Invite to team.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. Then I get your invitation.
Okay.
Okay.
Are you? Is that a Romulan warbird of some sort you're in?
Probably it's a Mogai. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's Morgu, not the Mogai. WC, we're Xing so that he could find out how to invite me to team.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yes, okay. I am going into it right now.
I'm going in too. Don't worry, WC, we weren't teaming for a mission. We're just teaming to do beta long call, which I haven't done before, as far as I know. The other one I haven't done.
Yeah, you have to, what the object is, you have to go up to these artifacts and scan them in.
Uh-huh.
But actually go ahead and just if you read the science report. What the deal is, when you scan it in, your science officer will have to tell you. Oh, good grief.
Well, it's giving me the option for Tholian patrols or scanning relics.
Yeah. Well, it's actually giving you information.
Oh, okay. So I got it.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're just going to go ahead and do things and kill.
Yeah, Tholian. Yeah. The object is not to kill the Tholians.
Oh.
The object is to pick up all the artifacts. And what you do is you go up to the artifact. You signal to beam it up.
Mm-hmm.
But you'll be given a certain piece of instructions, and you have to choose that out of the options given you.
Yes.
And you have a limited time to do it.
Okay, but.
And if you don't do it, then all you have to do is just scan up with safety. With safety interlocks, which basically takes a long time.
Okay.
When I say a long time, more like 3 or 4 seconds. So.
Just won't let me beam them up. Because there's Tholians here. This is interesting.
But yeah, once you get the first one, just choose the same option and all the rest of them, and they'll come right on up.
What are you eating? Please don't be eating my dinner. So apparently we're not in the same instance.
No, we're not in the same instance, but... Well, I think the fact that you're a Klingon character, aren't you?
No, I'm not. I'm a Federation.
Oh, are you?
Ah! Okay. Transport with safety interlocks? Is that what I do?
Yeah.
Okay.
And best thing to do, just kill everything close by.
Clearly.
And then scan it up.
Okay, so kill things, then scan. Got it.
Right.
Kill, then scan. I can do that part. Apparently not.
Apparently so.
Hey! Howdy, howdy.
Hey there, how's it going?
It's going good. How are you doing?
Tired, too much work.
I understand that, okay.
I figured I'd ask you first. You don't want the noodles and the tomato stuff.
Well, that isn't bad.
What isn't bad?
I gathered up most of the energy credits on most of my characters.
Mm-hmm.
And I might have enough to get something.
Woohoo! Well, either this ship is woefully underpowered or we're on a higher setting.
Oh my gosh.
What?
Someone just used the assimilated torpedo and assimilated one of the Voth Citadel ships. Or the Voth Citadel dreadnought in the sphere.
Really?
Really?
Yes!
I know, I gotta open up some boxes today.
That'll all have to wait for next week when I've got a little more money.
And next week, I know. Keys. Yeah, next weekend. Well, I still have a couple keys from what you gave me. I was going to open them late, and I didn't do that yet. But I did find some. I did find some lobby on one of my characters.
That's nice. Did you decide to buy anything?
I'm contemplating, but if I do that, I lose my proto-matter field. I'm contemplating the bioneural circuits.
Bioneural circuits are very nice, but do you have the tachyokinetic converters?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
I have a tier 5 tachyokinetic converter on Jason's ship. I would either be getting rid of the approaching AD console, the resonance emitter, because either one of those is 15% damage, phaser damage. Or I'd be getting rid of the protomatter field.
Yeah, protomatter field is nice, you know. But we've had that discussion many a time. Well, I've gotten 3 of these so far.
3 of what?
Of the relics. I'm doing beta long haul.
I did pick up the 7 guns the other day on my primary. I haven't upgraded them yet, but I will throw them into the strike group chat so you can take a look. 7's dual Tetrion rifles.
Ooh, speaking of 7, speaking of new series, speaking of dual Tetrion rifles, someone had suggested that instead of doing a bridge for Vegas, that we do Picard's Vineyard.
Then we could tell a story!
Get the Chateau Picard guys involved.
Oh god, no, don't put us by them again, please, no, not that! I mean, there were nice guys, but how many times do you need to hear that same story? We heard it a lot.
We did.
How do you think they felt after telling
them? Oh, you could tell just from their tone of voice. Yeah, did you know there really is a Chateau Picard? Oh, yes. Well, back in the day.
They hit it pretty well, except around us, but yeah.
Yeah. No, they were great. Let's be honest, by day 5 or 6 those last couple of days. Yes, it's Star Trek Online. You want to play? Good. Here's how you play. We're going to go get a drink of water, because we're good that way.
I really hope we can get a couple more people, because the thing that I kind of missed last year was being able to take a little bit of time, wander, hit panels, and things like that. I mean, we still wandered a couple things, but...
Well, Borg King has offered to help, as we've discussed.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So that would be cool. Well, that was an interesting one.
And we're combining with...
Hopefully with Pilot Review Show. I have to talk to him. Yeah. We chat occasionally, but not a lot.
Hopefully, if that works, then maybe we can put something together and do something.
That would be cool.
And I'm still trying to find a friend they keep waffling on. I'm going, you know, you should do it. Just get out there. You work with us. We cover. We're basically, because we're vendors, admissions covered, and boom. Then we just have fun.
Sav, I'm sorry that my firepower isn't up to your standards. That's the way it goes. Deal with it.
Where is Sav giving you grief?
In Discord chat. Sorry, in Twitch chat. Because she's Sav. Chat. Because she is Sav. Yeah. We can't all be you, Sav. Only you can be you. Relish it.
Sav, you think I should on my engineer replace my protomatter field with a tachyokinetic converter? Why? Because you would know.
So what do you think of Betalanka?
That was nice. It was a nice change. So there's something to do besides just shoot the crap out of things.
Yes. Have you... I keep forgetting how to pronounce it, but it is all the way to the Galordon Core?
Galordon.
Galordon Core.
Galordon Core. I have done it once or twice way back. It's been a long time since I've done Galordon Core.
That's the one where you had to herd the Gekli?
Oh, yeah. I used to do that a lot when I was doing the...
Romulan
one. Another one. It's either Narendra or Nequencia, where you have to do trading. I want to say it's Nequencia, because we usually do Narendra. Narendra. Why do they do that?
I don't remember that.
Yeah, somebody was mentioning it yesterday. Yesterday. But you go in and it's a trading mission versus a beating the crap out of people mission.
Yeah.
Just for a little variety. Oh, Narendra is fighting, so it's Nequencia then, Sav?
Yeah.
It's a Ferengi mission. We're trading stuff.
So if you put a turtle shell on a tribble, wouldn't that make it a Zenkethi tribble?
No.
Only if you gave it a slug face.
All right, I need to do
I've only killed 21 Tholian chips, and I'm supposed to have gotten 30.
Fine, let's go do Archer.
Okay, sounds good.
I'm on my way there to do that now.
Come on, let's go do Archer together, though. So.
Okay. Yeah. Well, but
Qantas, stick an X other here. Hold it. I'm not in charge of this one. Can you invite him?
Sure.
Since you're the team leader. He's down in chat.
Trimanix. Yep.
Trimanix.
Okay. You guys need anybody else?
Yeah. You want to jump in?
Sure.
We're going to Archer. We can just beat up things on Archer.
All right. I'll have to warp out there, but that's fine.
Okay. Jason?
Yes, yeah. He's Jason. You can shortcut it to New Romulus with some missions, but I don't think you can get any closer than that.
I'm just going to go jump out into sector space and slipstream it. I got to... Why? Because I actually got a pretty good amount of slipstreams.
What kind of ship you got here or there?
I'm running a Miracle Worker battle cruiser.
Oh, yeah, Miracle Worker, of course.
WC, yeah. Zenkethi Tribbles, they're cute when they're grumpy. I want you to go back and play one of the Zenkethi issues, or one of the Zenkethi missions, and in your head think girls just want to have fun when you're watching them run. Because they go in perfect rhythm. Thump, 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 thump. And I can't get it out of my head now.
Zenkethi just want to run.
Oh, the Zenkethi just want to
run.
Yeah, I actually want to do that as a music video if I ever get another day off. Something worked.
Days off? What are those things?
I don't know what they are. I actually didn't do anything today, which meant I worked on the quilt, made dinner, did grocery shopping. What else?
Oh, you're quilting, Kim.
Yeah, I do quilting. I love quilting, but in this case, the binding just fell off of an old quilt, and I'm replacing it. What, sweetie?
Yeah, when I was a little kid, my grandmother did a lot of quilting.
I learned.
I still have some of her quilts.
I still have the quilts that she made me. Not very many. Most of them have fallen to threads now. But yeah, I was the little kid who liked quilting, so I had to do the work of getting underneath the quilt for when the ladies dropped things, etc., etc. It was always kind of a hoot because these were the church ladies, of course, and they would be discussing the Bible when they were doing the quilting and all that, but I was kind of respected highly in the group because I was the only kid who was interested in it, and I still quilt by hand. None of this quilting by machine stuff. Yeah.
Well, I mean, my grandma, when I was a little kid, I kind of had this little, short-term big interest in old antique cars, like the old Model T era cars, and my grandmother made for a twin size bed, a quilt that had all of these old fashioned antique cars embroidered on them. Mm. She embroidered them herself by hand. I still have it. It's hanging in my hallway kind of as a tapestry.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that.
That's awesome. Is everybody ready to go in?
Yep.
Yes.
3, 2, 1, enter. My grandmother used to say that her quilts were to be used, and they didn't count as a real quilt until the baby peed on them.
Hmm.
So yeah, ours actually got used, but I have a beautiful one from her.
I've got two or three other ones that I actually do use.
Yep.
You know, I mean, I take good care of them.
Mm-hmm.
I cover up and keep warm, but I don't. They're precious.
Well, I have one that I'm working on that was going to be for my nephew for his wedding. Mm-hmm. His daughters are now 10 and 12. Still haven't finished it. If I ever get it done, I'll probably give it to Farnsworth.
Well, that wouldn't be...
Does anyone care if I get the space material?
Oh, no, go get it, please.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Go for it. I just want to murder stuff.
Yeah, yesterday I had space material and ground material. And something equally easy.
So as I get so many materials, actually, I hate to say it, I almost need more R&D.
Well, Ivo needed some Omnis, so I crafted one for him, and Ed crafted another one for him, because I had enough mats to just do that.
I can actually probably craft some Omnis, too.
Well, I didn't have two officers to do it, so I had to ask Ed to do one for me. I was not paying $12 million for Drolid just to do a set of Omnis. That thumping is the dog eating something plastic, by the way.
Oh, okay. I was thinking to say.
She, of course, decided the only place in the house that she can be at right now is at my feet, tearing up what I think is a salad container, or the lid from a salad box from a couple of days ago. I had to buy some new earbuds today to go to the gym. I bought them, left the store, and realized I couldn't open the package. It was one of those nice heavy plastic ones, sealed. No place to open it. No, I didn't have a knife with me. I finally got into the gym. I'm like, can I borrow a knife? And they're like, sure. Happens all the time.
I remember one time I had to buy a pair of wire cutters.
Mm-hmm.
And the type of packaging it was in required wire cutters to cut it open. Uh-huh. So I walked back in the store. I'm like, can you help me open this up?
Isn't it fun when there are lots of Tholians to kill?
Yes. Great fun.
On that same thought, I went to Hobby Lobby to buy a piece of ribbon. I actually needed two pieces of ribbon. So I said, I want a yard, but I want you guys to cut it in half. And they're like, oh, we can't do that. Run that by me again? You can't cut this in half? No, we can only sell you one piece. We can't sell you two pieces. Seriously? Yep. I said, well, can I buy it and borrow your scissors? Nope. Okay. So I bought a pair of scissors.
That was Hobby Lobby that was like that?
Yeah. So I bought a pair of scissors, cut it in half, and returned the scissors in front of them. They're like, well, you can do that. That's fine. I have no idea why they wouldn't let me do that, but what the heck? Well, that was fun.
Yeah.
Indeed.
Murder, death, kill, as Pi would say. Sof says you want right, irony getting a paper cut from a Band-Aid wrapper. So true. Well,
that's when you just can't win.
Mysterious MJ. Hi, welcome aboard. You're welcome to jump in chat and visit with us. Or if you're in the game, you're welcome to jump into the game. Yeah, Sov wins the internet. Okay, we have 182 days till Vegas. We have $50 of our $30,000 goal, which is still $50 closer than we were a few days ago.
I did not realize I did not have the Sally Ride on me until just now.
The what on you?
The USS Sally Ride, the Admiralty card?
No, you got to have the Sally Ride.
I didn't realize I didn't have it on this character until just now.
Yeah, absolutely.
I have it now, but...
That was fun when that came out. All right, what's next?
Yeah, wouldn't that meant for like some sort of fan-made movie?
Yeah, it was to honor them for doing that.
It wasn't a fan-made movie. It was actually they were playing the Star Trek Adventures tabletop game, and that was their ship from the game.
Oh.
And they're doing a new one, which is the skin on the legendary galaxy other legendary pack.
Okay. Okay, what was this
So we have the Tholian kill. What else do we have for a kill?
Okay, I've already got I've got Hurt frigates. I was planning on just doing
we can do swarm.
The first portion. Yeah.
We could do swarm and, get some points and stuff. Okay. If that's good for you. We're still teamed.
That's good for me.
Would anyone else like to join us for a little swarm?
Yeah, we got room for one more.
I'll do that.
Okay, stick an X down in chat.
And I meant, and I didn't mean the tachyon connect. I got that. I meant the bioneural circuits. That, so
that's what you meant.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Well, that's good.
Bio.
Who wants to join?
Just do the beginning of home much faster.
I agree.
Yeah, that's what I was going to do. Is just the first part of home was what I was going to do.
Okay. Like I said, we could.
But hey, let's do the swarm anyways, just because it's fun, more fun with friends. Is there anybody who wants to play that's not in already?
Yeah, I was going to say we've got the four of us already. WC, did you want to jump in? Sav, somebody else want to jump in for Swarm? I don't think Lance's playing, but anybody
somebody
else?
Somebody wants their phone picked up. I was like, no, we're not picking up the phone.
Okay. All right, going into it right now.
Okie dokie.
Beep-boop.
Oh, did you get Sav? You didn't get Sav.
Cancel.
Yeah.
Oh, too late.
Sav, we don't really like you, apparently. Am I the only one in here?
They did it.
We're in here.
Yeah. Of course we are. We're teamed.
That ambassador looks ugly. Green.
Oh, there you are. I was going to say, where's the Morgu?
I'm over here. Hi.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, you're the only one that's in front of me. I was looking at all the ships behind me.
Well, I'm going to go right since I'm in front.
Okay. I'll go ahead and hang a left.
I guess I'll start trying to kill stuff straight ahead.
Okay.
I'll just kill whatever comes around.
How about you just kill it all? Kill them all.
That's Sav's job.
Yeah, we'll just hang out. Let you do all the work. Of course, that kind of defeat the purpose of me coming here, because I came here to kill frigates.
Yeah, remember, don't kill the, what are they? The Ravagers. And the other things too fast, because those are what spawns.
Those are what?
The ones. They spawn the frigates. So if you shoot them out, then you don't get as many frigates.
Yeah.
Well, I guess if they shoot at me, they have to die.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Ah, I got killed. That's not good.
Oh, I've been killed!
You don't usually get killed that fast, but I'm not paying attention, I guess.
So it's the swarmers that we're wanting to kill, right?
Right. Yeah. Those are the frigates in this one.
So I'm getting a lot of these Ravengers.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing. Well, I mean, I got a couple Swarmers, but so far only two. And I got blown up because I'm not paying attention to my health. Of course, we have three waves, don't we?
Yes.
So I'm not.
How many do you need?
20.
Oh, no problem.
Oh, you'll get that easy.
Yeah, you can get 60 in this one if you. Oh, definitely got to redo the ship. Oh, we got six. There's three left.
Two.
Showing three. Two.
Now it shows two. One.
And I got mine. Still showing 8 of 9. Got it.
I'm okay. About to get 9.
All right. Cool. It's just a little slow. There we go. I'm going to take the Alpha satellite.
Oh. Yeah, I got the stuff down the middle. Then I went down, got the stuff on the left. And
Sav, I think I'm using spiral disruptors. Somebody had suggested that one as an experiment to replace whatever I'd been using. DT suggested. No, actually, it wasn't you. Somebody else.
I have a variety of disruptors. I've got...
Well, if you're going to Disruptors, Mom, you should pick up the Terran Rep one.
Okay. Do we like Disruptors on a Morgu, though?
I love Disruptors on my Morgu, I gotta tell you that.
See, what I've got on mine, that I've got, well, first of all, I've got the Nausicaan Torpedo, the Nausicaan Disruptor.
You do the Terran Rep one.
I got the House of Martok.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Sob, this is irony when you let loose the swarmers on the swarmers.
You watch my.
Okay, who's? Okay, we guess.
You watch me fight. It looks like I got a whole. Looks like I got a rainbow build, but it's all still disruptors. They're just different types of disruptors.
Disruptor mania.
Yes.
All right, I got a couple satellites done. So.
Did we get them all?
Yeah.
Okay. That's something I wish they would do. I wish they would do vanity beam colors.
Oh, Lord.
And cannon colors.
That would be cool, yeah.
It would be.
Yeah, I would love it. Then I would just freaking have all my phasers looking at like one thing.
I would have everything looking like, as far as like looks is concerned, my favorite is the Ferengi plasma.
What color is
and
that?
That's what I would do, because I like how the Ferengi plasma looks.
All right, I'm an alpha.
I'll float.
DT sounds like Bill Clinton, according to Sav. HFC, hi, how are you? HFC 7036.
DT sounds like Bill Clinton?
Well, here we go right now. We're going to have a little bit of fun here.
Not a bad, okay.
He did not have sexual relations with that woman.
No, he never says sexual relations. I think he says relations or something like that.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman. No, it was just a blowjob. Didn't mean much.
I always think that's so tacky. It didn't mean anything. What do you mean it didn't mean anything? Jeez.
Oh, I bet a whole lot when I had it.
Yeah, really.
Harassment. Harassment, nothing to me. Nothing.
I can always go the
it
other
took
direction.
Me a moment.
I can always go the other direction about this one.
Yeah.
Well, Mommy, we're going to have ourselves a little bit of fun now.
Oh, God. No. That's just like way too wrong.
Yeah.
WC says no.
No.
Ooh.
Suck my hollow kamikaze.
I was going to say there's ladies present, but it's just me and Sob, so it doesn't count.
Yeah, we all know you're not that much of a lady.
Oh!
Come on, that was wide open. If I did not take that shot.
Wide open.
Not going there either.
It was a moral imperative to actually make that comment.
Okay, the hive's over on beta.
All right, I see the hive. I'm going to be very, very quiet. I'm hive hunting.
Hive evaporates. Yeah, hive disappears into nothingness.
There was a hive.
Past tense being the operative word there, or operative term. Well, I still have to do tour of the galaxy, and some herald ships.
I actually, with this ship, I put the gamma core back on here.
Yeah,
and I actually did I did the entire alpha, or the entire beta quadrant, I should say.
I used to have my beta quadrant down pat.
Oh, I could do the whole thing.
Really?
Yes, I can do the whole thing.
Well, didn't you?
I've got Miracle Worker with the gamma quadrant.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Warp core and the Polaric module.
Yeah.
I think that's what it's called.
I
can do the whole thing. In fact, or in fact, me and Van Marcus was talking about it, and I kind of showed him how to do it on stream.
Oh, that was the other night, right?
Yeah.
I gotta put the Borg engines on here, the Gamma Core, which I have, and I gotta do the Polaric, of course, because this Miracle Worker ship loves slipstream.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Now, in order to get the whole thing done, you do have to kind of know how to fly it, because when you're not in slipstream and you just do kind of an auto navigate thing, mm-hmm. You know how it'll put you down to half impulse to make the sharp turns?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anytime you're using that gamma quadrant warp core, you have to turn it down to a quarter impulse to make that turn.
Hey, I have a question for you on it.
And you have to do that manually.
The one thing that always gets me is when I start it up, it never registers the first sector that I'm in.
You're too far. You have to fly to it. You have to be like,
yeah.
You have to be a couple light years out.
Okay.
Yeah, you actually have to go to it. So,
but with the old system where we were just going into the sectors and you could just clip the corners to get credit for them, that was a blast. Now I feel like you have to go in, go through the front desk, register, get your room keys before they let you go to the next one.
Yep. Find out that when you do automatic registration, it doesn't put you near where everybody else wants you. It's put you like three floors away.
Yeah, third floor facing west.
I remember that.
It works. Got to find a better
place. Then you have to go back to the front desk.
Gotcha.
And don't forget, when you do all this stuff, the other thing you need to do when you have your is, if you have the point, have your science there, so you can have that sector speed travel.
Oh, that's right. I had forgotten that. I should do it on this tune.
You might have to rechange a couple things.
Oh,
but
I definitely
still
do.
I've been actually building a lot of characters lately. Really, to get ultimate tactical skills, which are really nice for. Though I think there's going to be a part of me that wants to build like an ultimate science build to be the space wizardry. Doing well down there, Mom?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Nothing was going on in the Alpha Lane. Oops, there we go.
You want to put a tractor beam on me while my ship is facing you? Oh yeah, please.
I suppose I should put on some sound from the game, but sometimes it's very hard to hear you guys.
It is sometimes, but
it probably sounds better to folks out there.
I had to actually like switch over to my speaker, and then I have to be careful not to go watching. I have to make sure that I'm not on Twitch while I'm doing it, or else I get a I was going nuts trying to figure out, why is this stuff echoing? Why am I hearing stuff three or four times? And it's like, oh.
Voila.
Nice. Yeah, my headphones that I got, it's USB headphones.
Yeah, I do those
too. And they have two virtual channels.
Oh, nice.
And I have to set my computer on like the chat one, which is a mono. But when you get into the game, you can go to options and audio, and then you can select a different channel. And that allows me to mix.
Oh, very nice.
So,
I'll find out what you got for headphones later.
It's a SteelSeries.
Oh,
Arctica 7.
Oh, nice.
SteelSeries Arctica 7. I've been real happy with them too. I had never heard of Steel Series before buying these. I just having problems with my speakers, and I'm like, I need headphones anyway, so I went to Best Buy and got some headphones. I had no clue what I was going looking for, but the sales guy that spoke with me was a really good sales guy. And he's like, well, this is what I'd get. Never heard of him, started to trust him. Glad I did.
Well, I always enter the contests that they have, because they have stuff all the time that they're giving away, and I've never won any of it. Mm-hmm. And it's low on the priorities.
I got a Corsair headset, and it's really nice. It's comfortable.
I hear Corsair is really good. See what? Yeah, I was like, I don't want USB, but the guy recommended it. I didn't realize it was USB until I got here. But I'll be honest with you, I'm real happy with it.
I had a USB Logitech one, and I wanted to keep going to USB just because it's been works a lot better for what I do. So.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been really happy with it.
All right, who has other stuff to do?
Mercenary services for sale. Mercenary services.
I need to do Terran ground, but need to kill 10.
I would be happy to do Terran ground. What do we want to do? We could do Pahvo.
Pahvo, yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
We could do Pahvo, yeah. El Timu. What's it called for reality? Is it Pahvo Dissension?
I think so, yeah.
So, Sob, you think I should ditch out my...
We're going to team up on that
for bio neural circuits.
Give me an X and I'll send you a team invite.
Oh, good grief. My chat is misbehaving. Sorry.
That's okay.
There we go.
The German pawn.
Ooh. Here we go. We've got a fifth. Let's see if everybody accepts. Michael Andrews.
Andrews, welcome to the chaos that we really shouldn't be doing, but we do it anyway because we're crazy people.
Make sure.
Well, that's no fun if you're not crazy.
Get your toys together, everybody.
Let's see. What do I have? I have a machine gun. Yay.
Hold on. What do I need to do for ground? I need AP.
Lex knives.
No,
Lex
I don't.
I'm going to try out these plasma. New Tetrion guns.
Okay, I've got that. Do I have any AP on this tune? I've got to have AP on this tune. No, I don't have any AP on this tune. Unbelievable.
Go to your Borg or your Nakura tab and just get one off there.
Yeah. We can do it the easy way.
Okay.
Oh, I can't even do that. Give me
one
sec.
I'm
going to
try out these new Pahvo, these new Tetrion 7-9 guns.
You know, I think I might go to the 7-9 guns instead of the machine gun. Yeah, let's do the 7-9 guns. Why? I used them once already, but they're fun.
Which ones did you say were
They're
AP?
Fun to look at, if nothing else.
Yeah.
You said Nakara was AP?
Yeah, Nakara was AP, has a sonic point, and Omega.
Yeah, Omega's a AP. I think Temporal's AP as well.
Yeah, Temporal's AP. Chronoton's usually an AP.
Temporal.
And let me change out one thing here. Bring out my solar gateway to go with Layley Fields.
The heck with it. I'll just go ahead and do my... I only have to do 10,000 in AP damage. It's nothing. Oh, Mike, I didn't know that you were HFC.
So you know about the crazy we got going on here.
Well, yay. I'm glad that that's you.
You take about a 30-second break because I forgot to take my medicine.
Oh, go take your medicine. Don't want to miss that.
I did buy my bio-neurofusion circuitry for my ever-so-fun evil ship. I'm happy now.
Well, I am so glad that you're happy.
Oh, come on. I can possibly do more damage, plus it ups my hull some, so my ship gets tougher, so I can probably deal with not having an extra heal.
It's ground. We'll be fine.
Oh, I'm talking for the Pike's ultimate. Oh. Though clearly I gotta upgrade the hell out of it.
Don't really want to do that. I'll do that. I have way too much stuff that I never use. Two of these unopened. My goodness.
Because that's just how it goes.
What's gamma? Is Polaron?
Do I find anti-proton space or ground?
Ground. There we go. That'll work.
All right, and I even popped that new thing to Epic. Yay. All right, now it's time to play with the guns a little bit.
I still have way too much junk here.
That's a Romulan warbird.
Yep.
Because for some odd reason I thought it was a bird of prey.
Sob, thank you so much for the donation. That's very nice of you.
Awesome.
Wow. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
we're up to 0.2%. Woohoo! Okay, we got a little ways to go. Hey, yeah.
I think you got a little time though, don't you?
We have a half a year to go. Yeah. And we set the goal super high because, you know, if we can do everything that lets us, you know, go whole hog into it as opposed to what we usually do, which is figure out how to do it the cheapest possible way. Yeah, we've done on a shoestring. If we can cover the basics, we're good. And no, nobody's paying for our food, our shelter, our transportation, or any of that other stuff. We even bought our own cookies to give to Kel.
I know.
Oh, really? Are you talking about like Ambassador Kel?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got an email from or text from Ed at one point that Kel had been mentioning that, you know, they were tired and whatever and they needed cookies and green tea, so we went out and bought him cookies and green tea.
I take it he's a green tea kind of guy.
I guess.
Apparently so.
Okay.
Ooh, that actually is going to be nice. All right.
Actually, Sav, I can't figure any of this stuff out, so when I need to do things, I wait for Pi to come on. It's like, I'm incompetent, Pi. Can you help me?
I think kind of, and Pi did a great job.
Pi's done a great job. Now I need to figure out a few more detail-y things.
Yeah.
Actually, DT, you and I need to talk about something else not related to this at some point.
At some point.
At some point, yeah. But it might be helpful for you. Boy, doesn't that look pretty?
All right. Whoa, who are we waiting on? My critical severity. I'm ready.
Yeah,
my
no, critical,
I'm ready when my, you are.
Me too.
Critical severity is, oh, is everyone ready? 61%. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I've been waiting for you guys.
It's all about you.
It's always all about me. Let's see. What is that one? Discovery? I'll do all.
It's under discovery, by the way, yes.
Thank you. Pahvo Dissension Advanced. Everybody's good with that one?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Weewoo?
Yep.
Yeah. Weewoo.
Okay. Weewoo.
I don't know if I can get one idea with an engineer. Sav? If I can get one idea crit severity with an engineer, I will. Yeah, I probably got to change some duty officers. Yeah. Can't hurt to try.
Oh, Ed's promised to help me with some of my ships, starting with my other Morgu. Which I guess is a Mogai now.
The Mogai, it is my favorite ship on my Romulan.
Well, I've got the Mogai for my Rami alien.
Uh-huh. I haven't decided what my favorite ship is, because I've got a lot of ones that I really like.
Yeah, I mean, there's some I like the Sovereign. It's still one of my favorites.
Oh, good. I materialized right inside of you. How's that for awesome?
Yeah. It makes me feel very full.
This really... My God!
I'm so into you!
Get them back! Mom remembers that movie.
There we go. I have jumped free. That was weird.
Yeah.
Too bad. Yeah, those two were almost like Matt Damon and whatever. What's his face? I'm stuck on you.
There's a song, I'm So Into You. I can't remember who it was.
Transporter Accident, codename Galaxy Quest.
Hey, we have to start.
We beamed him inside out, and then he exploded.
Oh, gotcha. We need to put together our script and start figuring out how we're going to do it with our characters from the game. Make our little movie. All right.
All right.
Who's going where?
I'm going up here. Somebody want to go with me?
I'm with you. Yeah, we should go 2 and 3 and everybody gang up on the last one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's good that you're going with me. You're one of the few people who can keep up when I really want to go.
I was wondering why everybody was leaving so fast.
We had a running game to see who could, you know, get the best speed boots. Uh-huh.
Ah.
And Mom just hated me for such a long time.
Yeah. Until the winter event. Then I was just fine. Thank you very much.
Suck my ember. Don't you like me with two guns here?
Indeed. How many Terrans did you have to kill?
10. I'm done.
Yeah, I was going to say.
These are not bad weapons.
You talking about these dual rifles?
Yeah.
I like them.
I like them. Visual's good here.
Yeah, I tried them.
They'd still be really too tiny for my Gorn.
They're so cute on your Gorn. It's like the noisy cricket ones.
It's like little toys on my Gorn.
Yeah, exactly. They're cute.
The noisy cricket ones.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you sounded like that from Men in Black.
Yep.
Yeah.
I like how they put the ensign up in front. They're easier to kill that way.
Well, that's the Terran Empire way. All the low level guys are cannon fodder.
Yeah, but they'll never become high level guys if they keep that up.
That's the point. They don't want them to be high level guys. That's what.
Yeah, but even their high level guys go down pretty quick.
True.
Ooh, that's good.
I think one of my favorite lines from a movie, you shot him in the back. Well, his back was to me.
What's that from?
I can't remember the name of the movie. I think it was some Western movie called Draw or something like that.
See.
It's a good line.
See, a little interesting tidbit that I learned not too long ago.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's the second Harry Potter movie. Mm-hmm. Draco Malfoy makes a comment about, Goyle needing reading glasses. It says, reading? I didn't know you could read. Found out later that when they were filming that scene, the guy who played Draco Malfoy,
yeah,
he forgot his line. And that's what he said in place of the line he was supposed to say.
And it's good line. Sorry, you got killed.
And it's one of the funniest lines in the whole movie.
Another really awesome goof was in Lord of the Rings.
Mm-hmm.
When Viggo Mortensen caught that knife as Aragorn. Yeah. It was actually thrown at him.
Wow.
It wasn't supposed to be, and it actually was, or something like that.
All right, we need to go start 2. We're done here, right?
See, some of the best lines in a lot of movies are ad libs. In fact, Lord of the Rings, Gimli says this slim chance of success or something like that,
mm-hmm.
and then ends up with, what are we waiting for? That was an ad lib line.
It is a good line. Gotta remember to grab some better heels next time.
Following you guys. You don't shoot Mom. Shooting Mom's bad. You're not going to see.
Just barely got here and they're already.
Yeah, they were waiting for us. It's an ambush!
Oh, fortunately, I have ambush turrets.
Perfect! Me too.
I like ambush turrets.
Oh, yeah.
And I got a flaily bubble.
Flaily!
I don't have the flaily bubble.
Flaily bubbles are good. There's some in the fleet bank. There were some in the fleet plank bank. Just because flaily bubbles are awesome.
Yes.
I forgot I had that one on there.
I gotta get some Borg torpedoes. I gotta eventually get some Borg torpedoes so it can simulate ships.
The flaily bubble was good back there. Orbital cutting tractor beam, eh?
Yeah. It looks like there will be some fun Borg gear, so. I still think the most meta thing that can probably happen in this point is if you somehow assimilate a Borg ship.
Ooh, Borg Red Alert.
That would make Borg Red Alert really interesting.
What?
Assimilate Borg ships.
In Borg Red Alert?
Yes.
That would be interesting.
Mm-hmm. I think we're all over here now.
I think so.
Yeah, we are.
Somebody let out Fluffy.
Yeah. Denver's out. That's what I forgot to do. I was going to pick up some fabric to make the armor for my plushy laser raptors.
Forces may have arrived, but too late.
Really? All right.
Back to the spire.
Well done, everyone.
Mm-hmm.
All right, who's going where?
I'll take the little hill.
Okay.
I think I'll go up, since I'm around here, I'm going to go up to this one cliff area.
I'm going to be right here.
DT, I'm going to go, whoops, if I can get past that rock, I'll go up past you to the beam endpoint.
Right. I just keep throwing turrets down. They just murder everything, which is always fun.
Yes, that is fun.
Gotta do the crystal, man.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay.
Burn.
There they are. I knew they'd come up here.
Yikes, 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 yikes.
You okay? Yikes
in a row. Nothing a hypo can't solve.
I have my paradox corrector if we need it.
Can you handle around here, or?
Yep,
I'm good. We're losing Westfire.
Yeah, go on.
Okay, you got it back. All right. Head back to where you are, Mom.
Okie doke. Somebody's got an agonizer.
I got it right here.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you need a hand, I'll float over.
I'm good here.
I just died in the west.
Okay.
All right, I'll swing over back that way.
I used the corrector, so you should be okay now. Now we got
all right, I'm down here with the Terrans. This is going to be fun.
Goodbye, Terrans.
Okay, bye, let's go bye, ahead and...
Goodbye. Ah! I died. Well, that sucks. Good. I'm back down here, then.
And I see an agonizer. I'll go take care of that. Hey, flirty bubble, you Terran.
Let's see what this temporal thing does.
That's always ominous. Let's see what this does.
Yeah, well, I mean, I got a 3-piece set on my character, and it comes with this activatable that I've never actually tried before. Temporal stasis. Okay, I'm dead.
No, I'm out of saves.
Okay. That's okay.
There you go.
Hey.
At least dead.
Where's the other one?
I killed him earlier.
Oh, sweet. Well, that was nice.
Yes, it was.
Quite fun.
Yeah, always good.
And though they're not epic yet, those Terran rifles are very nice. Those seven rifles are very nice.
Yeah, you know what? I've got.
I need to zip back to.
I think I'm going to have a check because I tried them a little earlier today. And wasn't having very good luck, but I tried them again, and I had a little bit of luck with some. May have to have a change of heart on these things.
I upgraded mine to Mark 15, and they popped over to...
Mine's still fresh out of the pack. Mine's still fresh out of the box. Let me see. I think I got some... You know, I've got all these...
I will probably end up buying some more Phoenix upgrades later.
I've got these Romulan upgrades that I've never used. I might as well go ahead and use them.
And Susan in the chat says hi to you, Mom.
I said hi right back.
I see that.
Susan Olraciocium. Okay, that is one of the coolest names.
And we found out more about number one. It is actually...
Is it really his dog?
Apparently it is actually Patrick's dog. One of Patrick's rescues.
That's so sweet.
Okay.
Really is.
All right. All right. They're... Mine are up to 15 now. All right.
Number one still.
What?
What do we do next?
And I have to go answer that real quick. Well,
Susan,
thank you for the follow.
Following it.
Oh, that's really nice of you. Well, WC, nothing like overkill. Anything, I know he rescues pit bulls. Anything worth doing is worth overdoing. I know the story where they did the...
Oh, is it pit bulls that he rescues?
Well, he fostered one, and he wanted to keep the dog and take it back to England, but they don't permit pit bulls in England, in the UK.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and so I know that they were talking about fostering another one here, either in California or in Brooklyn, wherever they were at the time. And then last thing I had heard was they had gotten one of their own. Yay.
I read a really awesome, well, technically I listened to a really awesome book about the American Pit Bull.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't remember the name.
Oh, God.
Here.
My sister, way back when, used to breed and raise American Staffordshire Terriers, which are like... pre-pit bulls a bit, more purebred and less of what you see these days, but very, very similar. That same very tough dog, but those dogs are so sweet. And my sister was having a party with her husband, and the pit bulls were there, the staffies were there, and my husband was there for the first time. We were just engaged, and there was food at the low table, and there's food at every table. This is my sister's house. Of course, there's food every place. There's couple of quiches on the coffee table, and one of the pit bulls was sitting there looking at my husband, looking at the quiche. Finally got up, walked up, just took a piece off of it, and looked at my husband like, "You're not going to say anything, are you?" My husband didn't say anything. Everybody got very quiet.
Yes.
Mm.
That's because we're all in such deep thought.
We think about many things.
Here it is. I found it.
Oh, okay.
That's not what I wanted to do. View summary. Wow. It's the book is called Pit Bull Battle Over an American Icon by Bronan Dickey. Very good book. I really enjoyed it.
What's the name of it again?
Pit Bull : Battle Over an American Icon.
Okay. As soon as I put in battle, it came up. Oh, on sale through Chewy. I like that. It's such a cute doggy.
I got a new calendar by my desk. It's pit bull pictures. Little puppy pit bulls. Well, really not little puppy pit bulls, but I get a little puppy pit bull for February.
So cute. They are beautiful dogs. I'll rephrase that. They can be beautiful dogs. They can be poorly... bred and poorly raised, but they can be so sweet.
Don't tell Gabby she's not beautiful.
Gabby's beautiful. My Fifi is beautiful, too.
Because you know what Gabby will do? She'll knock you over and give you more attention than you can handle.
She knocked me over anyway. Hi, Funk.
You're my friend.
Well, I was trying to be your friend, and there was just a lot of energetic dog there.
You know, she's 11 years old.
Is she really?
Really?
She's very cute.
Did you get injured there, Mom?
I did. Did I have any heels? Nope. Not a one. So who has any endeavors left aside from destroy Herald chips and tour the galaxy?
I did mine this morning, so.
Good for you. I did Omegas this morning.
Yeah, mine are done, so.
Oh, that's
I had to
good.
Murder Zankath. I had to do Zankath in the battle zone. That.
Well, in the battle zone.
Oh, that's the thing, though. I haven't done anything event related today.
And then, and then I had Healy on the ground. So basically, I just walked over to Nakura, walked out, put down a med generator, turned off the environmental suit.
Getting naked on Nakura.
Need to work on my tan.
Yeah, it'd be one way to get good tan real quick.
Crispy. Whereas my husband would say Cripsy. All right, well, why don't we do something so everyone can get their daily for the event? We could do Hell with Honor.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Okay. Let me get some. What am I going to do with all this garbage in here?
I don't know.
So much trash.
Okay. Have you ever tried to use your WASD keys not realizing that you're typing all that stuff into chat?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there will be any number of times.
Usually I do that. I'm switching back and forth on Discord, so I look over on Discord. My ship's not moving. I'm looking over Discord. Damn.
Yeah. It's when my ship's not moving, I'm like, what the?
It's faster to just put it all in than just...
Yeah,
say
hit
it
that.
And just try and delete it.
Yeah, it's does it too. That's the best thing.
Yeah,
and now that we've done Ed's little hotkey thing for this character, then I'm like, there's numbers over there too. Time.
Moved a ton of stuff out of my account yesterday because I was moving supplies around so Ed could craft some omnis for me.
Yeah. I wonder how many omnis I could craft if I want. I don't know.
I need a phaser omni.
I'll craft you a phaser omni. Be done
Thank
tomorrow.
You.
That reminds me.
Hopefully I have everything to do the phaser omni. Let's find out.
It's not
apparently
too
I gotta
bad.
Craft a few I gotta craft a few pieces.
Okay. Oh, okay. Sav's gonna join us, so we'll start
All
keying
right.
in 5 minutes.
Okay.
So go ahead and do whatever you need to do, and then when she gets back we will start her up.
That sounds fun.
I think that'll be my last one for the evening, so we can all have a decent night's rest. And I have to go to work tomorrow. And I have to go to Bloomington tomorrow. Yay. Maybe yay. And I haven't finished the laundry yet, so I have no clean clothes for Bloomington. That's a problem.
All right.
Mom's on later now?
Well, you have to wait for the laundry to be done then.
I actually got out of bed at like 4 on Saturday because I thought, I haven't done my uniform pants. So they were in the washer, got everything, threw it into the dryer, it's drying, I get it out, my uniform pants aren't in there, and it's like, where are my uniform pants? I hadn't put them in the washer yet. So I wore really filthy trousers to class on Saturday, which I hate to do, you know, if you're teaching the class,
you want to look professional.
Yeah, really. It's my last pair of uniform pants, too, so... I have to decide if I'm going to spend more money on any more this year. Oh, Sav's ready.
Okay.
So we have Sav.
Count
me
in.
We have Jason. We have Qantas. And Jason.
I take this invite and I accept it.
Did everybody get an invitation?
It's an unusual way of spelling Jason.
Group's full.
It works.
Yeah, it works.
There was a lot of story behind it, but yeah. It's...
All right, everybody ready?
Ready.
Yep.
We will.
Wee-woo.
Wee-woo. Wee-woo.
Well, I panned over to beam out, and there's a Sandorian beaming out behind me. Creepy.
It happens. Yeah.
I know.
Oh, I'd forgotten that was the ship I'm flying, the Battle Mom. Oh my God!
The Battle Mom. Okay.
I still want to see Brondo Moogie.
Brondo Moogie will be coming up on the other character that I'm creating, on the other account I'm creating, which I'll probably steal one of our existing accounts if no one's using it. But Lexers is using Tie My Shoe. Ed's using Carl Pla. What was the one that we're going to do? Curland here?
Yeah.
We had some good ones.
You having a disagreement with what's her face?
Yeah. If I don't die, I'll be happy. Just need to let her know who's in charge here.
You're the captain now.
All right. Let's see if we can get all the frigates this time.
I got all the frigates in my last run of this today.
How did you?
We just missed one of the cruisers.
Okay. Well, Sav's got Delta. Probably doesn't need anybody to help her, but I'm going over there anyway. No, she doesn't need any help with anything. Whole planet's been devastated. Going over to Epsilon. Oops, there's Lukari.
So Epsilon's the only one left.
Mm-hmm.
And let me guess, it's way over there by the Lukari, right?
Yep. I'm beating up the Lukari at the moment.
Head over there.
Ah, I died.
We shall avenge you.
Oh, that's fine. I can avenge myself. Got honor my butt.
Hi, Jula. Cloak and run away.
Oh boy, man, she got me down to 20.
Yeah, but she had to run away. Where are you?
I am right where Jula just now warped out of.
Yeah, I can't. Yeah, you know, Sav and I. Look for Sav and I. We're all around here.
Might be too far away for me to help you.
Oops, they go boom.
Oh, Somebody's having a lot of fun taking out the reactors.
Huh?
Somebody's having fun taking out the reactors.
Yeah? Yeah, that one did get took out pretty quick.
Boom. White lights. WC, if your tune only has 3,000 GPL, I don't know what to say. It must be brand new. If we see it, and it's a big hole in the ground in blue like that, is that an Oculus Rift?
Is what?
There's a big blue thingy in the ground there where all the walkers are coming out of, and we can see it, so does that make it an Oculus Rift? Sorry, okay.
Don't know.
No, joke. It's a joke, don't worry. It's a bad plan, words.
Ocular Rift.
Yeah.
Oops, I disintegrated it.
Honey, I disintegrated the walker.
You know, I'm seeing a huge difference with those bioneural circuits. How did we do? 9 out of 10 again, 14 out of 18 on frigates. So.
Wow. Let's blame Sav.
Nah.
She's right there, too. Hi, Sav. That was fun.
Oh, 12 out of 20.
I'm seeing a huge difference, though, with that console, for sure.
I can't type. Herald ships. Yes, yes.
It says you logged off.
It says I logged off?
Yeah.
I did log off. Shoot, hang on. I'm still here. I'm still here. Da, 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 da. I really didn't log off.
You were changing characters?
I wasn't changing characters.
Oh, well, we can see what you're doing now.
Oh, good.
Going back to your launcher.
Well, can you see that? Now I'm on my launcher there?
Yeah.
Ooh, you can see all my cool stuff there.
Yeah.
And back.
Yep, you're back.
I'm back. Was that about Canada? Blame Canada. Yeah. It's all Sav's fault. She's Canadian.
Well, as you pointed out, you got a country being run by an underwear model.
She's the one who's pointed that out. Many people have pointed that out. I did not point that out. Okay, I'm going to re-roll my easy peasy one. Destroy Voth ships. Oh, Lord. It's a no-win situation sometimes.
True.
I wish it was easier to get to the Voth space zone.
Well, can't you transwarp there?
You can, but... You can go to Allied Sphere Space very easily.
And then you just beam then you just beam to the ground battle zone, then beam up.
But doesn't that take you to Undine?
No. If you go to the ground battle zone, then beam up to your ship, you're in that area with where all the Voth gather around.
Wow, that was faster. Yay. But it still keeps you here in the contested zone versus the Voth contested zone, but it gets you halfway across the map. So it's something. And since the one we really like is Targets of Opportunity, it would be fine if there's more targets in this section, but there aren't. Corvin Rhaegar, hi. Oof. No, I don't want to go to space on Dean. I want to go to Voth Zone. Okay, I guess I'm going to...
I'm going to be off for a few. I'm going to cook dinner.
Yeah, and this takes me back there. This is not where I want
to
be.
Even Sov in the game said go to the Voth ground battle zone and beam up. So, apparently we teach mom something new today.
Yeah, except it took me back to the... It didn't take me to the Voth zone. It took me to the contested zone, which is not where I
want
to go.
Oh, you want to go to the space battle zone? And just...
No, I didn't want to go to that one because that's easy enough to do. Okay, do ground... Back up.
Ooh.
I think it's part of the labeling. So on my mini map, see, you are in the contested zone, but this is supposedly the Voth zone, but it's not really the Voth zone. That's the Undine zone.
But that really
zone.
Is the Voth zone. The space battle. Well, technically, it is because at the end of that space battle zone, what do you have?
Voth.
Waves and waves and waves of Voth.
But not immediately. I wonder if I can fly through this thing.
Of course you can.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes, you have my permission to fly through the tube.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
There we go. Targets of Opportunity.
Change channel.
Okay. Why would you want to do anything like that for?
Because I don't really want to watch the green mile.
No, you really don't.
Green mile.
Movie?
Yeah, I know that. I thought it might be kind of a joke or something like that. What's wrong with the green mile?
I just don't want to watch it tonight.
I find it's a movie that, like a lot of others, it's good once, the second time, not so much.
I see.
Nothing wrong with it. There aren't a lot of movies.
Well, I've seen it twice, and I actually enjoyed it, so.
I've seen it enough times that I just I'm not.
Seen it so many times, you don't want to ever see it again. Is that what you're saying?
No, I'd rather go find anything else on.
There's a few movies I can watch over and over and over and really enjoy them. And weirdly enough, Lord of the Rings, the third one, yeah. The other ones, okay, but...
But the whole trilogy is just one movie.
What I'd like to find, and I don't think I can find it on Blu-ray. I'd like to get the whole Lord of the Rings thing on the extended.
Oh yeah, you can. I've got it actually.
All right.
Well, one of the movies I can watch over and over is In Harm's Way.
Hmm.
It's an old movie, but it's got enough layers that you know you don't get bored watching it over and over.
Yeah, movie I could watch over and over. And I know that a lot of people disagree with me on this, especially my parents. But a movie I could watch over and over is Serenity.
Yeah, I can see that.
The Firefly movie?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's one I can watch a lot, yeah.
It's got enough layers that you can watch it.
I watched it with my parents once. They didn't like it.
Oh, well.
But I liked it.
I hadn't seen Firefly when my husband took me to see Serenity.
Yeah, I saw the movie before the TV show myself.
Yeah. Well, but basically those spirit, how do you clean your spirit? You put it through the wash. It's still too soon, right?
It's pretty good.
I'm a leaf on the wind. Watch how I
leaf on the wind. Watch how I soar. Or is it watch how I soar or watch how I fly?
It's watch how I soar, but he never made it through that last part.
John Hughes movie night. That's a good idea. And yeah, I can watch Ghostbusters, the old one.
Yeah.
Repeatedly. It's still funny.
No. We're going to make you watch the remake.
No, we are not.
I hear the remake is horrible.
It's horrible.
It really is.
It's unfunny. It's been on TV lately.
Chris Hemsworth's the only thing funny about that, and that was... That's it. The people who are supposed to be funny aren't funny.
They aren't. It's not funny. Somebody did an analysis of, like, one really short scene, which I think lasted 12 seconds in the original and was a minute and a half in the remake. And they did a comparison of why it works in one and why it doesn't work in the other one. And it's not because it's women. It's not because it was men. It's because it was subtle.
Terrible.
It's because it was subtle?
Yeah. It's the scene in the elevator when they realize that they have a unlicensed, unregulated nuclear power supply on one of their backs and... The two people on the sides just...
You have an unlicensed nuclear accelerator on your back.
And the two guys on either side just kind of shift to each side. Just that. It's the only thing that happens. And the equivalent in the new one is...
Yeah, because they turn it on, it starts rumbling, and they just kind of back away.
Yep.
Yeah, I remember that scene.
Yeah. It's all facial and just a small bit that works.
And then, of course, there's the old classic Bill Murray point. What happened? He slimed me.
All right, what have I got here for equipment? Oh, goodness gracious, not much. Maybe this isn't the tune that's done it in the past. Or do I not care? Perhaps I just don't care today.
You know what was on the other night? Ghostbusters 2.
Not a great movie, but...
Still better than the remake.
Yes. Yes, excuse me, but Velocipaster is better than the remake.
I'm going to actually sit down and watch you Velocipaster.
You have to watch Velocipaster. It was amazing.
It's one of those movies that's so terrible, it's brilliant.
I like Federation ships. Why do you ask, pray tell? Velocipaster was excellent. It was a good movie. No, I like Federation ships at the moment, though. What have I got? Yeah, at the moment, I've just got my Rizian one and my Morgu. Almost everything else is in storage. And most of those aren't Federation. Most of those are just prize ships. I haven't purchased a lot of ships over the years.
I've lucked out usually, but I'll save money when I do stuff here and there. I haven't really been doing it lately, but well, I have for, because like I said, my intention is I'm going to get the legendary ship bundle. Why? Mm-hmm. Because, well, with all the skins, all the consoles and everything else, and the fact that it could be a very good thing.
Very nice rant, WC. I have nothing against Federation ships. I see lots of them that are truly awesome. But I have 11 tunes, and by the time I get done running everybody through the prize ships and the basic ships, I'm out of time. The only thing I've ever purchased is the Gemmy bundle. What was it, the Cardassian ships?
Yeah,
the Cardassian ships.
As the Cardassian ships, as the Jemadar ships, which you are totally in love with a carrier, I know that.
I am. But I will buy some Fetty ships one of these days. I do intend to get the bundle.
Yeah, because no matter what, limited time, it'll be back. Why? In one form or another, it will be back.
Hey, and Susan, if you've got a ship that you think is particularly fun, let me know.
Like I said, the one I've been having a blast with is the Gagarin.
Yeah, that's probably... I have 6 T6 coupons, 7 T6 coupons, and I haven't done any of them yet.
Through various accounts? How'd you get 6? They've only done it twice.
Because if you did donations to some of their events. And I did donations to some of their events.
Well, I will say, and Sal would probably agree, the Gagarin is just... It is a beautiful beast.
I agree, Larina. Family was an excellent episode, and it's one of the few times that they bothered to do a consequence episode.
Yeah. Which one? You know what I would have liked to see consequences from? That whole point where he was tortured by the Cardassians. And then he was telling Troy at the end of that episode, at the end, I actually saw 5 lights.
Yeah, actually, that's been one of the ones in fanfic that gets written up a lot because it needed a follow-up episode.
And Geordi's follow-up where he realized that they messed with his mind badly.
Sav, please tell me that you think Code of Honor was not the best episode ever. Please, please, please. Please tell me you're joking, Sav.
Code of Honor. Okay.
Thank you. She was joking.
I do consider myself a Star Trek fan. Mm-hmm. I cannot remember what episode Code of Honor is.
It's the first season. It's when Tasha gets kidnapped by the African equivalent warlord.
It was a very race.
Oh my
kind
god!
Of
oh, just
okay.
Horrible.
Yeah. I remember watching her in an interview saying that it was kind of a sexist one.
Do you know? You know what the best episode of all time for Star Trek: The Next Generation was?
Which one?
Sub Rosa.
I liked Sub Rosa. I did. It wasn't a great episode. I mean, screwed up canon royally.
It was a terrible.
Oh no, it wasn't a terrible episode. It was just not great.
But if it wasn't followed up by Lower Decks, it might have been.
I didn't like Lower Decks very much. Chains of Command was actually a really well-done episode. What's really funny is we saw Chains of Command at the same time that they were touring. I think 6 of them were touring with a group that was doing a piece that was raising money for, Amnesty International. And it touched on a lot of the same things, so there's this moment of kind of weird deja vu-ish going back and forth. Really interesting.
I think I got a mouse in my house.
You have a mouse in your house?
Yeah.
I had mice in the house, but we had a humane trap, and I trapped the mouse. Took it out to the field with a bag of potato chips and some corn so it would have something to eat. Came back in, my husband said, "You didn't get the mice." I'm like, "No, I got the mouse and took him out." And he's like, "Nope, there's more." So I caught a couple more. And the last one was trying to get out, and it was getting his nose a little bloody, trying to get out from the trap where we had him. I felt so bad for him. His claws were getting blood on him, and his nose had blood. I'm like, "Aw." I'm just not good with that stuff.
Well, I had set up a trap for this one, but he didn't fall for it. He just walked right around it.
Humane trap or a kill trap?
No, it's a kill trap.
No. Well, I won't tell you how to catch him.
And then, of course, there's another of your favorites. Yes. The episode Genesis.
Ah! Oh, God.
Okay, which one was that one?
That was the one... That was the one when they regressed, right?
Yep.
Yeah, there was some kind of virus, and it got into the atmosphere. It was Barclay had done something, or it was because of Barclay. And so people were regressing into earlier genetic forms. And
oh, okay, I know what you're talking about.
Did Deanna become like a spider?
She turned into some kind of water fish.
Barclay became more like a spider. Deanna became an amphibian. Worf became...
a venomous something or another.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Picard got scared. I mean, that was his regression.
He was going back. You know, he didn't get as far regressed as the others.
But... Data should have become an old laptop. That's awesome.
No.
That would have been funny.
No, not an old laptop. You remember the monkeys that banged the cymbals together?
I was about to say Trash Eddie. But I like the monkey idea better.
That's a good one. You win. Well, shall we do one more and call it an evening, everybody?
We can do that.
Hey, speaking of which, okay, Worf sprays Beverly with venom, right? In the face.
I think he sprayed Deanna, but...
Yeah. No, it was Beverly. Because
okay.
they put
I
him
don't
into...
know. It's been so long since I tried to even watch it.
Wow. And so they put her in stasis because they need to deal with it, but with everyone regressing and she's the doctor, there's no one around to deal with it. So how'd they deal with it? Yeah, I thought
Data,
Bev.
Data, because he was the only one who was completely unaffected. And Data is the... Deus Ex Machina to fix any problem.
Yeah, he's that. A lot of people who complain about TNG, Data is usually the reason why they can't figure out how to get out, so they just get Data to do something.
Or Wesley.
Well, it used to be Wesley.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, even Will Wheaton hated that whole point.
Sav says, "Shut up, Wesley."
And Will Wheaton went, "I don't want to hear Shut Up Wesley again." So Patrick Stewart responded on his Twitter, "Shut up, Will."
Yeah, and just think when he used the Data Wesley whatever solution, it's just bad writing.
Well, when you think about it, wasn't Spock kind of the same way in the original series?
No, he and Scotty got to share responsibility on that one.
Scotty got to share his responsibility for what?
For finding the great solutions.
Oh.
Yeah, they each had their share of that one.
Yeah. But, I mean, it's like, we're trapped in a cave. I think I can mind meld with the alien outside of the cave through the wall and make them do what, and make them let us go. I mean.
Yeah.
I mean.
Yeah.
I mean, I love the original series book, and forgive the language, anybody, but that's pulling someone straight out of your
butt. Straight out of your Shatner.
Yeah.
The one
of course,
the fun
ones were where Spock and Scotty worked together to save the ship.
The one on the planet when the shuttle had crashed, the Galileo 7.
Yeah.
That actually was a really good episode. I love the fact that, you know, Spock didn't quite know what to do and people weren't reacting the way he thought they should. And that was actually a good episode.
They weren't reacting logically, as it were.
Mm-hmm. See, they should have had more episodes in all of the series where things didn't quite go the way they were expected to.
Yep. Well, sometimes they did. I mean, Balance of Terror, things weren't going how they expected to have. And that's one of the greater episodes, I think, from the original series.
There was
okay.
There was one where Data was...
So we're going to do one more TSO or something?
We're going to do one more. One of the ones where Picard wasn't in charge of the ship. Data was in charge of one of the other ships, so it had to be a Romulan one.
Is that the one where they had to
find the cloaked Romulan
right,
ship?
That's the one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
The whole Klingon Civil War thing, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And the guy blatantly disrespects Data, and Data's mm-hmm. like, I understand your position. Do it anyway. I'm like, yes!
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. If you do this, you're going to flood the decks with radiation. Do it anyway.
Yeah. Tough to be the boss sometimes. Okay, last one up. What are we going to do?
How about just random?
Okay.
Full frontal nudity. Yeah, that's a very bad thing.
What? Did I miss something there?
I'm reading the chat.
There was this one episode in the first season where everybody in the ship got drunk.
It's the second episode. It's the Naked Now.
Tasha Yar wore a rather unforgettable dress.
Yeah, great dress.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That was a great
really
dress.
Unforgettable because years later, Data still has a hollow of her.
Oops.
But not in that dress.
True.
I've got WC here. Okay, the other awesome dress was in the one where the alien comes in and kind of usurps Deanna's energy so that he can live forever type thing. And she's got on this purple gown. You guys know which one I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Oh my God, that's a dress.
Deanna Troi with a purple gown.
Dark purple dress.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody remember which episode that was? Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, I'm trying to...
What was the name of the episode, though, folks?
Purple Gown.
Yeah.
I remember one where she wore a white gown that was kind of off the shoulder that...
Man of the People. Is
Man
of the
People, that's the one. Let's see if I can find an image from that. Because dang, that's a dress.
Found it.
Found it?
Found it.
It's an awesome dress.
In what season was it?
That's a good question.
I don't know what season
it is. The 129th episode, so season 6, episode 3.
There's the picture. I just threw it up in Discord.
We're in Discord.
Or stream Twitch, chat? I should say.
Oh, Twitch.
Yeah,
okay.
Stream.
On Twitch?
Yeah, I threw it up on the Twitch. The link for it, anyway.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, okay.
It's a great dress.
Yeah. It looks like it's translucent, but it doesn't. I don't think it's actually translucent.
It's not translucent. It's got a skin-colored mesh underneath it. I used to work in bridal shops, and that's a neat trick. If you want it to look really sexy, you put skin-colored fabric underneath it. We've only got two people. I've only got WC and Jason. Anybody else want to do a random TFO with us?
Sure.
Give me an X in chat. Got room for two more. Got room for one more. And we are full.
Cool.
All right, it's random, though.
That's what I asked for.
Okay. Everyone ready?
Give me a moment. I'm going to throw something up into the... what channel do we... Stream chat. Yeah. I'm throwing something in the stream chat. Another picture of the dress for you. In HD.
Well, Sav, in Insurrection, he also sank to the bottom and had to walk back to shore. So...
So how did it become a flotation device?
I have no idea. WC says it's a Sybil faulty hairdo. Yes, that was. Hard to get hull heal endeavor when your hull regen is over 300. Yeah, it is. Yeah. Too late, Maximus. We already got a full team going on here. I apologize, but we got a full team. Is everybody ready?
If one of you really wants to go, I'll step out, but...
Let's just go and...
Okay, let's go. Okay. And we'll do another one. We can always do another one if we have to.
We will. Well, this is my last one for the evening. I said that the last time, but I lied.
Yeah, I know. That's why there could be another one. You never know what's going to happen. Is it his motion chip? You left it behind.
Good night, Sav. Thanks so much for being here. We appreciate it. And thank you very much for the donation.
Sleep well. Have a good night. Always fun to murder things with you.
Yes, 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 indeed. I just remembered I also have to go text my son since he's off to a meeting tomorrow and I need him to do things for me at his meeting.
Yeah, unfortunately for me, they added more days.
Pahvo.
No.
Pahvo. It seems like we were just here.
We were just here.
Oh, sorry. I'm the one that said random. I'm sorry.
And this time I am in Starbright. So let me jump out of him. There we go. Deja vu all over again.
Excuse me, have we met before?
Oh, I've got my big plasma beam. Do I have any other good toys? I don't need that one.
Four, three, two, okay. One.
Oh, somebody brought their puppy with them, or kitty kitty. All right, let's see what we got.
Somebody forgot to blow up their own another device.
Somebody slacking.
No.
All right, where are we going?
I'm following you.
Okay, same as before.
Okay.
Yeah, I got stuck behind this rock again.
I'm following Starbright here.
Okay. Shout if
you need a hand. And her little doggy, too.
Shout if you need a hand.
I'll get you, my pretty, your little doggy, too.
I got back here.
Have
And apparently I'll get up here too.
You okay over there?
Oh, we're doing good.
So. Okay. On to the next one. There's nothing like Sompec lightning.
True. Thing, but I needed the extra health.
Keep saying place crystal. Oh, no wonder if there's more people over here.
They're sneaky that way.
Yes, they are.
Yeah, they're bad like that.
The crystal has been purified. Advance to the next one.
Can you hit a resurrect for me?
Yep. Does that work?
Yep.
Yeah. You wanna come save my butt now? Nope.
Can't. Both can't either.
Okay.
Big long respawn run.
Of course, because we're all the way at the end of it.
Yeah. Oops, I think I took the wrong way.
You did take the wrong way.
Hey, come and join us.
All right.
We're almost done.
I heard somebody do something, but I didn't see it. So.
Poetry, welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. I didn't see the name. Who was it?
It was...
Hello? Did I lose everyone? Everyone got so quiet.
Oh, I did. Looked like Overtree or something like that.
Well, whoever it was who just followed us, thank you. We appreciate it. It didn't pop up on my screen, so I'll have to go back and look at it in just a moment.
And it kind of... I kind of got a glimpse at it while I was doing it, though.
I was busy getting my butt dead over here. What happened? Why am I suddenly so crappy at this? Have we got all five, DT?
Yeah.
Okay. Ah, there goes Anne. So the thought of doing a game setting being a Picard vineyard is interesting, but where do we put the game consoles? That would be kind of fun. Different.
It would.
I don't suppose there's an option for personal mycelial rifts, is there? We can drop a rift on somebody.
Almost got this one done, then we'll... All right, that one's done.
Only one left. Through the waterfall.
I'm kind of running backwards towards. Across the river.
Over the river and through the woods. I do love the dramatic death scenes that they put in from all the characters. Falling to one knee, hand outstretched.
I'm headed for the last roundup.
It's the big one. Sorry.
I'm coming, Elizabeth.
This almost isn't fair.
It's not.
Still got wind in the big one yet.
That's purified.
All right, who's going where?
Okay, I'm up on a...
little hill, big hill.
I'm going right over here.
Okay. So you guys are
I don't know where here is, but it's right over here.
Oops, I'll go over on the big hill.
Start right near me. All right, two of you over here. I'm going to go.
Where's WC?
To... Looks like that's two of them over. Looks like he's over here, so I'll head over to where you are.
Okay. Oh, that was a nice solar gateway there.
Yep.
Whoever set that one up, that was lovely.
I did.
Sweet.
Huh.
Just fries them all.
Yep. Then there's the crystal turrets that just blast things as we go.
Somebody need help, or are we good?
Oh. Put one right beside me.
Yeah. West Spire. South Spire. That'll make things more fun.
Fried Terrans.
Southern Fried Terran.
Alright, let's go kill these guys. Yep.
Fight well, and I'll give you a quick death. Guess I can do this. You're not entirely
unskilled. Gary Lifeson, or soon be Gary Lifeless. Toodles, Desmond. I smell the fear on you from here,
weakling. He's dead.
Yep, that was short.
I always forget I have that orbital chase beam set up. It's like, hi, we beam down. Beam.
Blink, you're dead.
Oh, he's not dying yet. Lightning.
We did really good on that one, WC. We went fast. Yeah. And those guys died. Died.
Yeah. Well.
Okay, now I am going to log off. I've got to do one more thing. And then I'm off to bed, everybody. So, on behalf of the Dark Mom Consortium.
Mr. Dave has a question for you before you go.
Mom, have you put in a request to do a panel for STO? What? Which? Hmm? A request
maybe
where?
They're suggesting. For the con, I guess.
Can we do that?
I guess we can. I don't know.
Night-night. Hey, Mr. Dave, I would love to do a panel for Stolen Gameplay. I hadn't even thought about it. Are you talking about for Vegas? Sorry, my leg decided to...
It'd be funny if we can coordinate with some of the people we have met from Cryptic and have...
Did I lose everyone? I got really quiet there.
Nope. Mr. Dave says, I would love a gameplay panel for STO.
I don't know if they'll let us do that, but... Yeah, well, that'd be way cool. I've done panels at,
I've never done a panel.
I've done panels at anime conventions.
We wrote a book.
We wrote a book? Yeah, I did a panel on...
that would be kind of fun to do a panel.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm expert enough to be part of a panel, but still, it'd be kind of fun.
I think we could figure that one out. Yeah, I can get in touch with them and see if they do stuff like that. I don't know. I can find out.
I don't know.
I can find out.
Apocalypse Survivor, Ezri. Wonder if it's Ezri Dax.
That's an interesting question.
What are we looking at? Yeah, it is worth an ask.
Is any any background information on Ezra is G-13 classified? Please contact Starfleet. An envoy will be sent to fetch you. Interesting.
Hmm. What's that from?
Must be someone's bio.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And I'm guessing this person is down where I'm about to jump to.
Yeah, she's over here by the ship manager.
I see that. Playing the accordion.
Yes. I need to come up with a bio for this character. But I'm trying to figure out how to incorporate a vampire into the Star Trek timeline.
Go to watch that Troy episode, the person who was that we had the dress from, because that was a psychic vampire that she was involved with.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, but this is not a psychic. This is not a psychic vampire. This is an underworld vampire.
TOS, you have the salt vampires too. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's a lot of points here. It can be put together. I think there was a vampire-ish creature in DS9 too at one point.
Let me rephrase that. I'm trying to figure out what kind of story, what kind of biography would be good for a Starfleet officer who was born in the Middle Ages.
Because
I named this character after a character that was born in the Middle Ages.
I can't remember the name of this freaking species, but that they called them. But
oh, the one the Guinan was?
No,
that's Elorians.
No, we're not doing an El. No, I was talking
no,
about
no, no. I don't want to do.
I was talking about the people who sponsored and re-engineered Gary 7.
Oh, yeah, that's one we don't hear about too often.
Because Gary 7 was already was given an incredibly long lifespan, apparently. So. Mm-hmm. That might be an angle.
Yeah, maybe. I'll have to come up with something for her. Yep. You know, because I named her after Selene from Underworld.
Ah.
And I want to try to go with something real similar to that. Because, I mean, Jack Fixer, I named him after Repairman Jack, and I've got a bio on him that made him a political fixer.
Yeah.
And Flint Fireforge, I kind of copped out, said he came from a different universe.
Oh, Jason, which is the weird point on the spelling on his name, was actually a character I used for some sort of Star Trek game, so. Well, before I started playing STL. Hmm. Frank came up with a name, so I just kind of carried over, which was why it's the weird spelling on him.
I see. Well, Timberwolf is playing.
Anyway.
I'm trying to find one particular episode.
Ah, this vampire thing got you thinking.
No, but the concept got me thinking. Da, 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 yeah. Da, da. It's not it. Where's that name?
Well, now you got me thinking of.
Let's see if I.
No. Goodness.
But yeah, if we can get a panel, that would be really interesting. Be really crazy, to be honest.
Oh gosh, darn it!
You realize that somehow we would have to have video recorded, and then we can post up. We had a panel. make a lot of stuff to do this thing, but to do this Omni, but you know what? We're going to do it.
Okay. I just made an Omni for my Klingon character. I'm going to get that set up a little bit. So I'm changing characters.
Gosh darn it, I cannot remember this episode. I can't see a name that looks right either. Requiem for Methuselah.
Flint. Yeah.
Flint, yes, thank you. He can't die. He's supposedly a human who can't die.
Well, technically by leaving Earth they said he could die, but then but then there was novels that said he either fooled people or was wrong.
Right. But the whole point is there you've got a premise. This could be Flint. Your character, who's been around since Middle Ages, could be Flint.
Yeah, that's Flint. Flint Fireforge is my Klingon.
Oh, okay. Well, it was just an idea. Wow.
What was an idea?
Basing your character, the one that your middle age, named after the Middle Ages.
Yeah, Selene. I named her Selene after the vampire on Underworld.
In the Underworld, yeah.
Well, I was just thinking you could make her backstory akin to Flint's from Requiem for Methuselah.
Which means they were born immortal, mistaken for various things, lived various lives. Kind of like Highlander when you think about it.
I'm thinking about just going ahead and making her Selene and just saying that she lived in secret for so long. And
well, there you go.
So,
hey, it's your story. You can do anything you want to. That's the joy of
it. True. That's true.
I almost want to make a character named McCall.
For some odd reason, my chat just popped up saying I failed to join voice chat, and I don't know why. But anyway, yeah, I just got on my Klingon character because I just made him an Omni Tetrion.
Uh-huh.
And I put it on my Tetrion build, which is a carrier. I'm going to have some fun with it.
I'm going to log off. I've been saying that for almost an hour now. So, folks, on behalf of the Dark Bomb Consortium, I'm going to go and do some other stuff. Like, stuff. So have
She's going to go claim to have a life.
Yeah. Actually, no, I'm going to go claim to need some sleep. I don't know if we're going to have a stream tomorrow. It depends on what time I get home. So, have a good night, everyone. On behalf of everybody
good night.
Here, take care. Say bye.
Yeah, you too.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye, bye everyone.
Bye. Have a good night.
Oh, by the way, Pi says check your Facebook.
I'm going to check my Facebook. It says check UFB don't. I don't know what that means. But we'll find out more. To check my FB, don't right now. And I'll turn off the microphones too. Bye.